afternoon, everyone, and welcome to our carols here at St. Andrew's. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Michael, and I'm the assistant minister here at St. Andrew's, and we're delighted that you could be with us this afternoon, whether you're here with us in the building or whether you're going to be joining us on YouTube. Everything you need for the service is going to be in the service sheet that you should hopefully have found waiting for you on your pew, or if you're joining us on YouTube, then it's going to be in a PDF in the comments down below the video. If you're in the building, we ask that you please follow all public health guidelines, especially around the wearing of masks. And we ask that you please sing along with the carols in your heart and not out loud, and that you remain seated throughout the service. So as we begin our service, let's begin with an ancient Advent prayer. O wisdom, coming forth from the mouth of the Most High, reaching from one end to the other mightily, and sweetly ordering all things, come and teach us the way of prudence. Amen. Well, we're going to have our first carol now, which is Once in Royal David City. So I'm going to invite our musicians, Joy, Sue, Ben, Sally, and Linda, up to lead us in that.
Oh, Our reading can be found on the service sheets and comes from the Gospel of John, chapter 1, verses 1 to 14. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as the witness about the light, that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to bear witness about the light. The true light, which gives light to everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to his own, and his own people did not receive him. But to all who did receive him, he gave the right to become children of God, who are born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God.
It's wonderful to hear those carols so beautifully sung and played. Thank you so much, all of you. We're really enjoying it. And I think we do need a little bit of Christmas cheer this year, don't we? It's been quite a year. I saw on the front of one of the newspapers the other day a little cartoon, and somebody on it was writing a round robin. And on their round robin, I think they said something like, this year, saw no one, did nothing, went nowhere. And I think that's pretty much the case for all of us, isn't it? I don't know whether you ever get round robins. We sometimes get ones from very talented friends who have families who are exceedingly talented, you know, the kind of thing, you know, Tarquin passed his grade 8 harpsichord this year, just in time to start school. There was one actually that was printed in the paper where the parent complained that their daughter wasn't streamed in some subjects and had to cope with the frustration of sitting with dim children. I don't know whether you get those. Anyway, this year, it will be sweet revenge, won't it, for all the recipients of the multi-talented families round robins, because nobody has done anything at all in 2020. It has been a challenging year, hasn't it? Incredibly challenging for some people. Some have faced the loss of jobs, loss of health, continuing long COVID. Had a friend who was down with that for about 6 months. The challenge of working from home. You have that extra challenge, don't you, of making sure that the home looks nice all the week through, where people can get this permanent window into your home from the office. And you have the trouble of trying to make a serious work Zoom call while the dog is barking in the background and the children are running in and asking for things, and you're trying to get some work done, and the Amazon driver who turns up every half hour is calling at the door. We've been through that many times, I think. But of course, for some, it is a much more seriously challenging year, and for some, it may even involve the loss of loved ones. I certainly know a number of people in that situation as a result of coronavirus. And as the winter darkness draws in, thankfully, the Christmas story does have brightness and hope for us. It gives us light in the darkness. Perhaps there is an echo in the Christmas story of some of the difficulties of this year, in the story of Joseph and Mary. It wasn't a lockdown, but nevertheless, the government had made a decree, an edict. It was more of a lockout, really. Everyone had to leave their homes and go back to their ancestral homelands. So there are Joseph and Mary going traveling, the great disruption to ordinary life. They couldn't even Zoom home from where they were going. And they had the hardship of living on the road, perhaps being a little uncertain about whether they were going to find somewhere to stay, and that was a narrow squeak. And feeling, I guess, like events in the wider world were taking over their lives, and they were losing control of everything going in their life. But John tells us that there is hope in the baby that was born that Christmas. Verse 4 of the little reading we had earlier says, "In him, in Jesus, was life, and the life was the light of men." Jesus is light in the darkness for us, hope in 2020. You may feel that 2020, personally, has been a tough year in all kinds of ways, perhaps ones that I can't imagine. A journey, perhaps, for some, through what the Bible calls the valley of the shadow of death. But the good news here is that Jesus is light in the darkness. And why is that? Two reasons why he's light in the darkness in this passage. The first is because of who he is. So, very first verse that John opens his account of Jesus' life. He says, "In the beginning was the Word." He's talking about Jesus there. "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God." Who is this baby? What's his identity? What would it show on his driving license? That he is God himself, come down as a human baby to meet us. Geraint Evans is a Welsh farmer, and he had no girlfriend, he said, because he had to work till 11 o'clock every night. He just never had the chance to get out and meet anyone. And he advertised his face on 2,000 milk cartons. It's a novel response, isn't it? And he was surprised to find a response from a 21-year-old American student. And they exchanged emails for some time. And then when they met, they decided to get married. It's a lovely story. So, chaps, if you are wondering how to do it, milk cartons is the way. It is a lovely story. It's a bit Gavin and Stacey, isn't it? Christmas special. How can we know, though, if God is really for us? How can we know what he's really like? How can we know how he is towards us? How can we know if there is a meaning in all our present trials? How can we know if we are on our own through it all or not? The birth of Jesus tells us that God has come to meet us face to face, and he wants to have a relationship with us. Not a flash in a pan, but a long-term eternal relationship. We can know him, we can know that God truly loves us when we look at this baby born in Bethlehem. He has come to meet us. So he's light in the darkness because of who he is, but he's also light in the darkness because of the gift he gives. Verse 9, a little bit further down, says, "The true light, which gives light to everyone, was coming into the world." There's a story in the paper of a shopping centre. Lots of parents were there with their children, and they had come to see the Santa in his grotto. An alarm bell went off in the background, and the Santa came tearing out of his grotto, shouting and swearing at everybody to get out of the building, and sort of pushing people out of the way. He barged into some 50 children and their parents, apparently. And apparently he'd been sort of panicked by the alarm going off. I guess they don't get those much at the North Pole. One of the parents said, "We told our children he wasn't the real Santa. He was an imposter, and he will be going on the naughty list." And quite right, too, don't you think? An imposter sounds like that. You don't want an imposter, you want the real thing. You don't want an imposter because he won't give the good gifts that Christmas is all about. But Jesus, because his identity, he's truly God, we can be sure that he will give us just what we need. He will give us the best gift of all, the gift of himself. The very source of all light and life, truth, goodness, beauty, hope is in him, the one who created them all. Just this morning, I was talking to a lady whose husband had been a millionaire, and he lost everything due to a crooked bank, as was later shown in court. And as he struggled with the loss of everything, really, that he had, then he read this passage and came to know the light in the darkness, the hope that can carry us through the most difficult times. He came to know the true God and to have the source of light and life in his own heart. And he was able to face the dark years of fighting the bank, fighting for justice, and finally was able to face death, the ultimate darkness, because he had the light within him. Now, I wonder whether you have that light yourself this Christmas within you, whether you have that hope, whether you have that certainty that you know the true God, that you have a relationship with him that will go on not just for this life, but for all eternity. Isn't that what we need? Many people speak as if turning the calendar onto January the 1st, 2021, will bring the whole nightmare of 2020 to an end, that's what will begin a new chapter. But actually, John says, no, there's one thing that can bring a fresh start, the turning of the page, a new chapter, the move from BC to AD in your life. And that, he says, is to receive this gift. Now, I have here in my pocket, and I've got a few on the back table there, copies of the Gospel of John. We've just looked at the first few verses here. I'd love you to read the rest of it. so that you might know and receive that gift of life and light in the darkness for yourself. Do ask me for one. They're on the back table. If you're watching us on YouTube, get in touch, martin@standrewsnorwich.org. Be very happy to pop a little Christmas present in the post for you.
Stable with me in your mind's eye to Mary, and let's see what she saw about her baby Jesus in her eyes. She couldn't fully understand what was going to be, but she understood some things. Please come with me to her.
Thank you.
day the angel came, it seemed that everything had changed. The only certain thing was the child that moved within. On the road that would not end, winding down to Bethlehem. So far away from home. Just a blanket on the floor of a vacant cattle stall. But there the child was born. She held him in her arms. And as she laid him down to sleep, she wondered, will it always be? So bitter and so sweet. And did she see there in the straw by his head?
She smelled me.
Let's turn to the Lord in prayer together. If you, at the bidding, Lord, in your mercy, if you would respond with, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, we praise you and thank you that you came to be light shining in the darkness. We praise you that the darkness has not overcome your light. We praise you that the darkness cannot overcome your light. Shine your light into our hearts today, into the hearts of our family, friends, colleagues, bosses and employees, into the lives of all across our city who especially need your light in our dark times. Fill us with your light so that it will shine forth out of us as a witness to you, the true light, that more people would come to know you as the source of life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We lift before you the needs of our country and the needs of countries all across the world in the ongoing fight against COVID-19. We praise you and thank you that the first vaccine has been approved after months of amazing effort, and that this is now starting to be rolled out. We pray that everyone who needs the vaccine urgently would be able to get it all across the world, promptly and justly and fairly. We pray for our leaders and those who advise them as they continue to have to make difficult choices. Grant them wisdom and clarity. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all who are sick, whether in body or mind, in this season, and for those for who, for one reason or another, the Christmas season is particularly difficult. We pray that you would draw close to them, granting them a sense of your light and life shining in their darknesses. We pray especially for those who will be alone at Christmas, those who will spend it on the streets, those who will spend it away from their families, working to keep us safe. Please, Lord, may this be a season of light and life for them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Amen. Well, before we have our final carol this afternoon, I'd just like to draw your attention to the final page of your service sheet, which has the details of our upcoming services here at St. Andrew's. You'd be more than welcome to join us either on Sunday at 10 o'clock or on Christmas Day, also 10 o'clock, or indeed on both days at 10 o'clock and going forward. And also just looking ahead to the new year, which feels so far away at the moment. Thursday lunchtimes here at St. Andrew's, we have a little talk, a little reflection on a Bible passage for some of the workers here in the city centre, and it's a chance just to take some time out of a busy work week and focus on God for 45 minutes or so. And if you'd like more information about that, do feel free to email either martin@standrewsnorwich.org or michael@standrewsnorwich.org. Or even if you think, well, I'm not sure I want anything as regular as that, but I might just like someone to have a chat to sometime, whether there's something going on at work or home, or you just want someone to chat to. We're always very happy to meet up with people or to talk on the phone or even to set up a Zoom. So again, martin or michael@standrewsnorwich.org. And as our musicians come up to lead us in our final carol, Hark the Herald Angels Sing, I just want to say a big thank you to all our musicians for leading us so well this afternoon, and also to Stephen and Peter for making everything happen technically behind the scenes. So we'll now close with Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Glory to the newborn.
Together as we finish. Lord Jesus, as we prepare to go back out into the world, back to the rest of our days, whatever that may hold for us, we ask that your message of light and life would fill our hearts, that it would encourage us, that it would strengthen us, that it would spur us on. In your name we ask. Amen.